Welcome back to Butler Professional Farrier School. Several years ago, we posted a video on a foundered pony. This is the pony that we first saw at our school 5 years ago. She had been crippled due to founder caused by neglect. She was to be sold at auction. We purchased her and made a video of the trimming and shoeing of her feet. Within a few months, following a period of therapeutic trimming and shoeing, she was again healthy and sound. And now after these several years, she shows no signs of pain as a result of founder and is now barefoot. She only needed the heart bar shoes to temporarily transfer the weight off the wall while the damaged lamina healed. She has grown a new hoof. She lives in a pen with other ponies that are loved and ridden by my grandchildren. Routine hoof care and good feed have kept her pain-free all this time. She is developing some arthritis due to her old age, but she gets around very well and appears to be very comfortable. We encourage all farriers and potential farriers to get training that will make it possible for them to help save these special animals. And we offer this at Butler Professional Farrier School.
It has been interesting to be here more or less one year later, because I find I found all the horses that I worked on in the last class, and most of them was lame, and now they are feel good. And so that means that our job and what Dr. Butler and his staff teach is good, because that horse that 1 year ago were lame now are going good.
Where in the different places that I've been, navicular and founder are considered, that's the end. I mean, the horse might as well have a broken leg and you might as well put him down. And this was the first time that I've known that there was a way to help those, but I never understood it or I never experienced it. Being here and we shot a foundered horse and seeing instant satisfaction from the horse and being able to help him, instant relief, and understanding why it is that we treat the way that we do, is just made all the world of difference to me.